गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम हियर विथ अ वेरी सिंपल एक्टिविटी विच आई बिलीव एवरी वन अमंगस्ट यू मस्ट हैव आइदर सीन और हैज डन हिमसेल्फ और हरसेल्फ। दिस एक्टिविटी नीड्स यू टू हैव सम वेरी सिंपल थिंग्स लाइक अ ग्लास, यू नीड सम वाटर एंड यू नीड अ कवर। होल्ड ऑन, आई नो यू मस्ट हैव गेस्ट this activity, but then there is something deep in this particular activity, so please hold on. Without putting some water, now if I cover this glass with this lid like so, and if I ask you what is there inside, the obvious answer is air. What is outside this? Air. And the air exerts some pressure. As I told you, you have guessed that activity. Let us try to do with air itself. If I flip this tumbler glass like so, and if I release this cover lid, what is expected? Okay, let's see. So it comes out. It succumbs under the influence of gravity. However hard I try, it doesn't stick. Explanation. Inside there is air at some pressure, say P. Outside this, here, outside this glass, there is air at same pressure P. If somehow I evacuate this air inside the glass, then inside the pressure will be less, outside pressure will be more, which I am not doing. And in that case, it will remain stuck. For that, you need some vacuum pump. But right now, the pressure inside and outside is same. And that's why this cover lid falls, because it is acted upon by the gravity. So on this cover lid, there are three forces. Gravity in downward direction. Outside or external air is exerting a force in upward direction normal to the surface, and the air which is inside this glass, that exerts a force on this cover lid from top in downward direction. So let me indicate these forces. So this is the cover lid. Outside air, it exerts a force in upward direction. This is the glass. The air inside the glass exerts a force in downward direction. And there is a force due to gravity, which I write as W. This is F1, this is F2. Now F1 is equal to P1, or I write Fi and Fo, inside and outside. Fi is equal to pressure inside into this area. Fo is equal to force from outside air, is pressure of air outside this tumbler into area. Since Pi is equal to P0, hence Fi is equal to F0. So the only unbalanced force is W, that is weight of the lid, and that's why it falls. So you have seen in your textbook students that somehow if you remove the air, so the simplest way is to put water in this. Now I'm coming to the activity which you must have thought in your mind, and it is said that you fill it to the brim such that there should not be any air, and then carefully put the cover lid like so. Let me put some more water. It is almost till the brim. Now put the cover lid, hold it tight, and then you were given a question that there should not be any air bubble. Of course, I got a bit, but let me try with this. And then carefully we should relieve our external force, and it sticks. But that's not the end. The explanation which is taught to us, which is given in the books, let me first discuss that. So there they say, now inside we have only water. We have only water. Outside there is air, and this is the cover lid. That air exerts a pressure, because of which there is a force, as I have explained earlier. Force is pressure into area in upward direction. The weight of this lid is W, and this water inside, there is no air, so there is no question of pressure due to air, but there is water. So this length of water, this is about 10 centimeter length of water, it has its own weight. It exerts some force on this lid in downward direction, that is weight of, I say, water. Atmospheric pressure is roughly 1 atm in this room where I am performing this activity. So calculations show that this force P naught A in upward direction is greater than the weight of water plus the weight of lid. Since upward force is more, that's why that lid sticks. But hold on. This is what is actually taught to us. This is what we know. So the answer to this comes from the atmospheric pressure. But what if I do not fill till the brim? If I do not fill this glass till the brim, there will be some air. Let me fill it to this extent. It is not even half filled, almost half filled. So this much portion is air, and this air is at same pressure as the air outside this glass. I cover with the same lid. If we accept this as the only correct explanation, now before we see what happens, let us try to draw number 3 figure. Now we have a glass. Inside that glass we have water, and we also have air inside that. So number 3 I'll draw here. So we have glass, we have that cover lid. The water, when you invert it, the water comes down, and this top portion will be air. Suppose this much is water and this one is air, and this air is at the same pressure, I presume P naught, as the pressure of air outside, that is P naught. Here also P naught, here also P naught. So if you draw the free body diagram, the forces acting on the lid, water will exert a force in downward direction, that is equal to weight of water. The lid's weight itself will act in downward direction, that is the weight of lid. Outside air, atmosphere, it exerts a force in upward direction. That force we have discussed is P naught into A. Now this inside air also exerts some force, and that force will be in downward direction, like so. And that force will also be how much? This pressure into this area, that pressure is P naught, area is A. Now if you see, there are 4 forces, this W in downward direction, this in upward direction, this in downward direction. Now if you see this downward force of P naught A, this upward force of P naught A, this would cancel. These two must cancel. So the only downward force that remains are the weight due to the lid and due to water. There is no force in upward direction to balance it. And therefore the lid must fall down. Lid must fall down. If we assume this to be correct, this explanation, there is nothing wrong in this. It seems at least in the beginning. Let us now try to verify it experimentally. So this is what a genuine logical reasoning looks like. It has to be supported by activity or experiment. Let us now perform the experiment. I have water in which I have filled the I have a glass in which I fill water till this portion. Above this there is air, and that air is at same pressure as the pressure outside this glass. I cover it with the lid. I invert it like so. I hold it tightly. We should expect this lid to fall. If this assumption is correct, if this explanation is correct. So Let me try to do it slowly. What happened? Where did we go wrong? This cannot be wrong. We must trust our eyes and this activity, this experiment cannot be wrong. So there must be something going wrong in this particular explanation. This is air at same pressure as this air outside. So this would cancel each other's force. So the weight of water and the lid must push them downward, but this is not correct. So something deep is there in this particular activity. In fact, I can take any amount of water. Let me take out some more water. This glass is completely empty. I'll put very small amount of water. This much amount of water. And this much is air. This much portion is air. And very small portion of column of the glass is water. Let me see if I could succeed in repeating that same activity. I have inverted the glass. This much portion is water and the entire column is of air, which is at same pressure as pressure outside. I don't know whether that's correct or not, but it seems. Let me see if I could succeed. Yes. So please, students, first thing that you should take out of your mind is this activity that water must be filled till the brim. No, I have shown you. Let me take out some more water. Now we have very small amount of water, very, very small amount of water. I do not know whether I'll succeed in this attempt or not, but let me let my confidence do the work. There is very small amount of water. Oh, my goodness. Very small amount of water. Actually, you cannot see from the top. Even that water layer is not completely over this. Only at the edges I find that particular water column over this lid. So please remove this concept from your mind that air should not be there inside the glass. Yes, air can be there. And if there is air, as in this particular figure, what is the correct explanation? Please pause the video. Do not see this video completely. I urge you, sincerely, students, to find the answer yourself. That will give you pleasure. After you have got some answers, resume this video. It may take 1 day, 2 days, 1 week or so. Do not see beyond this particular video. Once you have got some answer, please resume the video and see the explanation part. Here goes the explanation. What happens actually when you invert this tumbler? I take some water. I cover with the lid. Right now, the air inside this tumbler glass is at same pressure as the air outside, no doubt. There must be something happening when I turn this. When I turn this, what happens? This air comes up, water goes down, gravity plays the role, buoyancy plays the role. This water tries to leak out from the edge. This is not watertight. I have not put any glue or something. This tries to come out and it does come out. If you perform the experiment, in the beginning you will find some amount of water does try to come out. Very small amount of water, very small. Water under its own weight compresses also negligibly. It tries to compress itself, this water. When it gets compressed or when a very small amount of it comes out, there is a fact called as surface tension. That surface tension, to some extent, it helps the water molecules bind themselves as a layer between this glass and this lid. That's why this water doesn't come out completely, but that is not the only complete answer. When that water slightly gets compressed, what happens to the volume that air is occupying? When water tries to come out, the volume of air which is present inside this glass increases. And here lies the clue. When volume of this air increases, its pressure decreases slightly below the atmospheric pressure. Initially, these two pressures were same. The pressure inside and the pressure outside were same. But when you invert this, few drops of water do come out of this edge of the water, because of which, and because of the adhesive property due to surface tension, it remains stuck over here. Water gets slightly compressed and therefore the volume available to the air increases. It expands a bit. Because air expands a bit, volume increases, pressure will decrease. You must know this is a very common law. So we have PV is equal to constant, so P proportional to 1 by V. Because pressure decreases, inside and outside pressures are now no longer same. Inside pressure is less, outside pressure is more. So higher pressure to lower pressure, there is a net force. That force is helping to counterbalance the weight of this lid and the weight of this water and very small weight of the air. This is the correct explanation. So where did we go wrong? We went wrong in stating that these two pressures are same. If outside pressure is P naught, inside pressure, if I write Pi, then Pi is slightly less than P naught. So this Pi A is in downward direction. This P naught A is in upward direction. These two do not cancel. Pi is less, P naught is more. So there is net upward force. Net upward force will be P naught minus Pi into A. This is downward, this is upward. So upward minus downward. This much force is acting upward, and this must be equal to weight of lid plus weight of water. That was the expression to this particular activity. So always think of those things. Always remember, things which look very simple may not be as simple as you think. There can be at times some deep meaning inside a particular observation, and that is the thing. That is the thing which you should try to inculcate in your minds. Always quest. Always try to find the things which are hidden in a simple observation. So thank you for being with me. I hope you like this particular demonstration. If possible, I'll come up with some more in the next video. Thank you, students.